Hello and welcome to watch this video about the Learning, Education and Technology Master's Program at the University of Oulu. I'm Goharshad, your host, and I have two dear guests from the program here with me. Let's start with a brief introduction. Hello and welcome. Can we know about your name and your affiliation in the program?
Thank you. My name is Kristiina Mänty. I'm a university lecturer in the LET master's program and also a program director.
Nice to have you here. Thank you. And what about you?
Hello, I'm Sophie. I'm from the UK originally and I'm here as a first year LET student.
That's great. Welcome again. Let's start with Sophie and how you decided to study in this specific program at the University of Oulu.
So I had heard about the education in Finland being of a very high standard, and that made me interested to consider a master's here. And then when I was looking at the master's programs on offer in education, this one really caught my eye because it was education and technology together. And having had a bit of a background in technology already, I was interested to see how I could further that and further my knowledge in that area. And then in terms of Oulu itself, I looked into the city, and it's a beautiful city that has wonderful nature all around it as well. And then, of course, there's the Northern Lights here. So that really pulled me and made me interested to apply here.
That's perfect to hear that. Kristiina, can you share a little bit about the basics of the program and what are the main focuses?
Yes, sure. The main focus is, of course, knowing how to learn. So we have we start with kind of understanding the basic processes of learning, kind of cognitive, motivational, emotional and social aspects of learning. That is the basis of our program. And then we have courses that deal with how to apply this knowledge to the use of technologies and education in different learning settings, and how to kind of also develop ways to and digital solutions to apply this knowledge into education.
Sounds really interesting. Sophie, you already mentioned about your technology background. Would you explain more about your background and how it relates to the program?
Of course. So my undergraduate degree was in media production. So I did a lot of things like filming and audio, podcasting and radio activities. And then I, after a few years, trained as a teacher and got my postgraduate certificate in education in the UK. And then I've been teaching as a primary school teacher for 5 years. But during that time, because of my interest in media previously, I took on the computing curriculum leader role in my school. And I had a lot to do with developing the curriculum for my school and for schools in my wider area. That then led on to lots of other things, like I ran a code club, after school club, and I also teach other teachers how to use computing in their curriculum for their schools. So all of that led me to this course so I could further understand how to best use technology and education together.
All right, I can see the connection already really obviously, but I wonder if all students are from the same background or are from different and diverse backgrounds.
Our students are from very diverse backgrounds, and actually that is the strength of our program also, because we can also learn from each other and get new perspectives on this learning and educational technology field. Our students come from, for example, well, educational background, and then a technical background, economics, and many different fields, who of course have this interest and this orientation to this educational field.
That's really nice. So as I understand, you are encouraging whoever is interested in the program from any background to apply if it's possible for them to relate to the field.
Definitely. Welcome.
Nice. So speaking of applying, Sophie, would you share about your application process and what was your experience?
So when I applied, it was all through the Study Info website, which was really easy to use. I was a little worried that it being a Finnish application, that it might be kind of tricky to understand, but it wasn't at all. There were two main parts to my application. The first was a motivation letter, where I had to write about what was it about the course that really interested me, what did I have in my background that meant I would be suitable for this course, and all of those kind of things. And the second part was a research proposal, all about what I might want to research if I do get on the course. And that's thinking about what interests you about the course and what areas you have experienced in the past that might interest you and make you want to research that more. So that was really interesting. Then, of course, there's the section about all your previous qualifications and submitting all of those kind of documents as well. So it was really interesting and easy to do on the Study Info website.
That's really great. I would like to mention that each year you can find updated information about the application process through the Study Info website. And Kristiina, do you have any tips for future applicants?
Yes, I think that the biggest thing to remember when you apply to this program is to show your genuine interest into the field of learning sciences and educational technology. To be yourself and show the interest in a good way, then you are fine with your application.
Thank you. I hope that it helps future students, and I'm sure that it will. Let's come to the moment that after choosing program and applying, students finally are here and you have a really fresh experience on that. What was the first year be like till now, and what kind of courses you have taken, and is anything particularly drawing your attention about the teaching methods or course materials?
So I started my learning here in Finland on the Kickstarter language course. So I started in August and did 4 weeks intensive Finnish language learning, which was really helpful to get acquainted with Oulu and Finland. And I made lots of international friends that way. So it was a really good way to start my life here in Finland. Then when it came to starting the LET course, so far there's been a range of courses that I've been learning about, one of which is called Orientation to Master Studies, which just gets learners ready and familiar with that higher level of education and get us ready for their master's level learning. And that's really interesting as well, because we get to hear about lots of different research studies that are going on around the university at the minute, specifically in the Faculty of Education. And that's really interesting to see what's happening and what we might be able to be included in the future. Another course that I'm doing is called Learning Environments and Technologies. And in that course, we learn about lots of different tech, how to use it, and how to then implement it within learning and education settings. So that's really interesting. In terms of the learning, there's lots of collaborative tasks that go on. And that's really nice to get to know everybody on the course and everybody's different backgrounds, as you mentioned. And everyone has such a different point of view that it's really interesting to pull from that and hear that and then use that in our own learning. So that's a really good thing that I've found so far.
Wow, that sounds really interesting. What about the second year? What's happening mainly in the second year? Is there any master thesis to complete?
Yes, as this is a master's program, we have a master's thesis that kind of completes the whole studies. We start this process already in the first year, and overall, I would say that the first year is where the magic happens. So there we have lots of different types of courses, theoretical courses on the learning processes, and then more technology-oriented courses, where students can explore this educational technology field and things that are happening currently and the future prospects of educational technology. And then we have these project courses for working life, where you can kind of engage in developing solutions for educational problems in different organizations, and you can also design learning. But the master's thesis process begins already during the first year. We started in the spring of the first year, where we start to kind of see your interest. You can show your interest and apply for different supervisors. Who can be the best for your topics of interest, and then you start the process of master's thesis from there on. We have the master's seminars for the second year.
Perfect. So let's move forward after graduation. What are possible job opportunities for LET graduates, Kristiina?
Well, I think that today, every workplace, every organization needs abilities to learn, adapt, and transform the workplace, the practices in the workplace in a new way. Because all of this fast technology development and also the changes in the society, they kind of require us to change and adapt. And therefore, we need those experts who know how to do this, who can lead the change by knowing what learning is, by leading the learning processes, and being able to design and lead collaboration in different teams and different these communities. And of course, knowing the field of technology and being able to analyze it towards the future, or the kind of future prospects that there are happening, or you can anticipate happening. So those people who have these abilities are at the core of today's and future's work life. And this is the message that we also get from work life right now. So I think that the prospects for a career are very broad from our program. There are people who have graduated from our program who have continued with PhD, so they kind of want to explore more about this learning sciences topics, learning processes in this new era of AI, for example. And then there are people who have progressed to different organizations in educational field, in industry. They can be learning designers, coordinators, project managers, and so on. So there are many different possibilities. But these people who graduate from the LET Master's program are really needed in our society.
It seems really promising. Thank you. What about you, Sophie? Do you already have some plans in your mind?
It's hard to say for sure, because over the next 2 years, who knows what I will find out, and who knows what I'll be interested in over my master's journey. But currently, I'm quite interested in policy and writing policy on how technology should be used for learning. So I'm thinking possibly I could go into something to write some policies for either companies or governments to suggest how they should be using tech effectively and appropriately in their workplace or educational setting.
Wow, all the best for your journey. It sounds really interesting already. And thank you, both of you, for being here with us and for this insightful conversation. And thank you, viewers, for watching us. And if you like to have more information about the program, you can check our website, oulu.fi. Thank you again, and goodbye.